square root or a scary root? Ooh, possibly it won't be that scary once you see this video tutorial. Hey friends, I'm Sunish from Team MAST, and in this video I'm gonna show you how to find a scary root, or square root instead, of a number within seconds. Wait, what's this? Calculator? Do we need that? Nah. So let's see the trick. Suppose the number is 625. I'm taking it from the very basic, so I'm taking the 3-digit number at very basic steps. So the very first step is start dividing the number into pairs, starting from the rightmost corner. What I mean is 25 makes one pair, 6 makes another pair. Now guess any number whose square is less than equal to the first pair number. So 1 square is 1, it's less than 6. But you have to keep in mind, while selecting the number, it should be such that it should be closest to the number 6. See, 2 square is 4, which is more closer to 6 as compared to 1. So we select the number 2, whose square is 4, which is less than 6. Now subtract it from the 6, gives 2. Now bring the second pair down. So the number now is 225. Now, next step is double the number, double the previous guessed out number, which was 2. So 2 cross 2 is 4. Now the last step is guess the number x, which when multiplied with the number 4x gives the output less than or equal to the number 225. So if the number x is 5, so 45 cross 5 gives the output exactly to be 225. So the remainder now is 0. So this is the perfect square root of the number 625. Now let's take one more example. This time a 4-digit number 3721. As with the very first step, start dividing into pairs, starting from the rightmost corner. So 21 makes one pair, 37 makes the another one. Now guess any number whose square is less than or equal to the first pair number, that is 37. So I'll guess the number 6. 6 square is 36, which is just less than or equal to the number 37. So subtract it from 37, gives me 1. Bring the second pair down, so the number now is 121. Now the next step was to double the previous guessed out number. Previous guessed out number was 6. Now 2 cross 6 is 12. So, and the final step was guess the number x, which when multiplied with the number 12x, such that it gives me the answer equal to, less than equal to, the number 121. As you can clearly see it, if we guess x to be 1, it's exactly same as 121. So 121 cross 1 is 121. So again, the remainder comes out to be 0. That simply means 61 is the perfect square root of the number 3721. Let's take one more example. This time a 5-digit number. As with the very first step, start dividing into pairs from the rightmost corner. So 29 makes one pair, 51 makes the another one, the leftover 1 makes the third pair. Now guess the number such that whose square is less than or equal to the first pair number. Now the first pair number here is 1. So 1 square is 1, so we take the number 1. Now second step was to subtract it and bring the second pair down. Now guess the number, before that we have to double the previous guessed out number. So 2 cross 1 is 2. So what we have to do is now guess the number x, which when multiplied with the number 2x gives me the answer less than equal to the number 51. So if x is 2, that simply means 22 cross 2 is 44, which is less than equal to the number 51. So now subtract it from 51, gives me 7. Bring the third pair down, the number now is 729. Now, we'll repeat the steps again. What we did was, we had to double the previous guessed out number. So in this case, the previous guessed out number was this 2. The arrow points out to this 2. So we double this number. 2 cross 2 is 4. And we bring the second, the previous to the previous number as it is down. So 2 comes as it is. Now, the final step, guess the number x, which when multiplied with the number 24x gives me the output less than or equal to the number 729. So what we see is 243. If the number x is 3, the number becomes 243, which when multiplied with 3 gives me the output exactly to be 729. Again, the remainder comes out to be 0. So which simply means 123 is a square root, perfect square root of the number 15129. Now let's take the final example with a 6-digit number. So very first step was to divide into pairs. 49 makes one pair, 74 the another, 12 the last pair. Now guess the number whose square is less than or equal to the first pair number. So it would be 3 cross 3, 9. So it's smaller than 12, so subtracted. Now bring the second pair down. So the number now is 374. Now again, double the previous guessed out number. So 3 cross 2 would be 6. Now again, guess the number x, which when multiplied with the number 6x gives me the output less than or equal to the number 374. If I guess x to be 6, so 66 cross 6 is 396, which is slightly greater than the number 374, so we'll discard it. Now we guess the number x to be 5, so now 65 cross 5, it gives me the number 325, so subtract it from the number 374, so it gives me 49. Bring the last pair down, 49 to be the final number which I can see. And repeating the steps again, what we did was to double the previous guessed out number. The previous guessed out number here was 5, so doubling it, 2 cross 5 is 10, so 0 and 1 carry to the previous 6, so it becomes 7. Now the final step, as it says, guess the number x, which when multiplied with the number 70x gives me the output less than or equal to the number 4949. As you can see, it can be intelligently guessed out that if the number is 7, x is 7, because 7 square is 49, and you can see the number which we have to match is 49, so possibly 707 cross 7, which gives me the answer exactly to be 4949. Subtracting it gives me remainder to be 0, which simply means x is 7 here, and 357 is the perfect square root of this number 127449. Note this thing: when the number is not a perfect square, the remainder doesn't come out to be 0. For all the above cases we discussed, we got a remainder to be 0, which meant that they were all perfect squares. Yeah, method seems to be somewhat confusing, but mind it, this trick saves loops of time for all those bank exams and all, where time is the only barrier. This trick gonna help you amazingly. Don't worry, keep watching the video twice, thrice, and so, and finally, there you are when you are able to calculate the long number square roots within seconds, believe me. Feel free to ask anything via the comment section below, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to our channel Team MAST, as there are a lot more videos coming on.